1 year in, and the only thing Biden is shutting down is his very own presidency. His approval rating taken to the woodshed again, dropping to a record low 33%. Doesn't get much better on the big issues, where he's underwater on the economy, foreign policy, and the pandemic. Making matters worse is the VP, who's not sounding very confident about 2024.
Are we going to see the same Democratic ticket in 2024?
I'm sorry, we are thinking about today. I mean, honestly, I know why you're asking the question, because this is the part of the punditry and the right. The gossip around places like Washington, D.C. Let me just tell you something. We're focused on the things in front of us.
There's been some talk about a Biden-Cheney ticket, perhaps, in 2024. Did you read that article?
I did not. I did not. And I really could care less about the high-class gossip on these issues.
Oh, man, she is so sick of this job. You can just feel it pouring out of her. It's sad but entertaining. Jesse, okay, the polls for Joe are lower than CNN's ratings. And they're nowhere near, I mean, it's amazing to me. They're now lower than Trump, but he nowhere near had the kind of mob rule media that Trump had. So imagine if the press coverage for Trump and Joe were actually equal. Joe wouldn't even be in the office right now. I mean, the fact he's lower than Trump and he's got the media on his side. It's insane.
It is insane. Can I read you a list of things that are more popular than Joe Biden?
Please do. I like lists.
Dentists are more popular than Biden. Bugs. Ooh. Bugs are more popular than Joe Biden. Nope. The Confederate flag is more popular than the president. Broccoli.
Whoa, I don't like that one.
Is more popular than the president. Donald Trump, 2 weeks after January 6th, more popular than Joe Biden. And Nancy Pelosi, by a hair, is more popular than Joe Biden. The only thing.
By an eyebrow.
Right. By an eyebrow. The only thing that Biden is, I think, more popular than?
Mm-hmm.
Your taste in music.
Oh.
That was Quinnipiac also. They put that in at the end.
Unnecessary.
It's clear, though. It's about the fundamentals. If you make Americans' lives more expensive, more dangerous, and more inconvenient, and then you don't inspire them at all, yeah, you're going to have terrible poll numbers. This guy needs a big moment. He needs, like, a breakthrough in cancer. Mm-hmm. He needs, like, a harrowing hostage rescue. You know, he needs to show us the UFO that they've been hiding in New Mexico. Something big that's going to kind of trigger our national pride that kind of rubs off on him a little bit. The guy needs a Hail Mary.
Yeah. Like, you know, maybe he might discover that MASH was canceled. You know, I guess we'll go to you, Geraldo. Can you expect, can the president expect his numbers to be good when America is seeking unity, but he keeps doubling down on demonization? It's like he already wrote off half of America, and then in the next day he writes off, I don't know, independence. He seems a bit like no one likes to be insulted every day, including even you, Geraldo.
I think that's right. I would think you're confusing the cause and the effect. I think the cause of his disquiet is the fact that he is the effect, that this unpopularity, the fact that people don't like him as much as they did, the fact that he's being blamed for these big issues, foreign policy, the economy, the tepid and confused response to COVID. But I heard Lindsey Graham, I think it was with Martha McCallum earlier today, saying Donald Trump is the leader of this party, like it or not. Get behind Trump or get out. And he was really targeting Mitch McConnell when he said that. And I started thinking about that, and I wondered about Trump. Now, is Biden's loss Trump's gain? You know, what about Trump? And you know, it's interesting that you point out that Biden is at 33% approval. 33% of the people want Trump to run for president. 59% of the people do not want Trump to run for president. So 33% do not want him to run. His disapproval is the same as Biden's disapproval. I think what you're going to see is, interestingly enough, no one can project or forecast, but I think maybe it'll be Hillary Clinton versus Mike Pence. You know, it'll be a fascinating run, because right now he is, as you point out correctly, Greg, in the gutter.
Yes, in the gutter. Nice. You know, Judge, Geraldo brings up Trump, and there is kind of an interesting problem in that Joe Biden keeps bringing up Trump as a comparison in these speeches, but then it just makes Trump look better in that rearview mirror. It's like when you bring up the comparison, it should make you look better, but it's actually making Trump look better.
What they're trying to do, and what they've been trying to do for a while, is make everything about Donald Trump. So an election in Georgia or an election in Colorado or wherever is about Donald Trump. We need to reject Donald Trump. And these hearings for January 6th are all about rejecting Donald Trump. And what they don't realize is the more they say it, the more people are thinking about Donald Trump and saying, gee, you know, the economy was better. And, you know, my 401k, to the extent you had one, and at least he was fighting for Americans. At least he was getting hostages out of other countries. And so it's just a dumb thing. But I want to say something about Kamala Harris. You know, every time she's asked a question, she says, I don't want to get into the high class gossip. And she says, I'm focused on affordable child care. So she turns herself into this wonderful person who's worried about child care. This from the same administration where the head of the Department of Education contacts the Department of Justice and the FBI and the White House so that they can turn parents into domestic terrorists and then go after parents. But then they stand up in front of the American public and say, we're out there trying to protect children and affordable child care, when basically they're trying to turn our children into little Marxists, and they're trying to just change the way America works in terms of school. I just think everything that they do is smoke and mirrors, and it's backwards, and the Americans get it.
Oh, if it only was smoke and mirrors, at least that would be fun. Dana, would you like to hear an interesting theory that I came up with this morning in the shower?
I love your theories.
Okay, here you go. Regarding Biden's falling poll numbers, it's because if you look at this comparison between Trump and Joe Biden, Trump used Twitter to drive the dialogue, whereas Twitter is using Joe, meaning that Joe is being driven by the loudest, most extreme voices on Twitter, whereas Trump actually did the reverse. So we have a president that's kind of like lost control of his own narrative and is indulging the louder voices. He's not leading the conversation, he's chasing it. What do you think of that theory?
I think it's a very good theory. I will add to it, which is that the best thing that could happen to Joe Biden right now is for Twitter to allow Donald Trump back on it.
Oh, very good point.
Because they would be able to raise money, they would be able to say, see, I told you. I came up with a list as well, Greg.
Yes.
And now the Quinnipiac number is about 5% below, 5 points below where most of the other polls have him. Still, it's really bad, and I also think it's probably not that much of an outlier, and I think we'll see that in the weeks ahead. But this is in the 4 days of this week. This is what's happened. He went down to Georgia. He got stood up by Stacey Abrams and by the voting rights groups. His own party, Senate Majority Whip said, yeah, you might have gone too far in that speech down in Georgia when you called everybody racist. You got a 33% approval rating. He went to the Hill to try to twist arms on the filibuster, and you had a senator on the very same day go to the floor and say, no, not so fast, that's not going to happen. Then, while he's there, as Jesse pointed out, they send him a note that says the Supreme Court just ruled and you just got kicked in the teeth when it comes to the Supreme Court. And then Manchin once again put out an extensive statement saying he's not for Build Back Better. Like, that's a pretty bad 4 days, and there's no mercy rule in politics or in polling, but they might wish for one.
Excellent point.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.